Hello everyone, welcome to Legalversity YouTube channel. In this video, I am going to share with you how you can use Turnitin account as student for checking your plagiarism. In the end of this video, I will also share with you a website where you can learn more about plagiarism, its research and its misuse. Come on, let's see how you can use or submit your thesis and articles to Turnitin for getting a plagiarism report. Just log in with email and password and click login. I'm using a student account as you can see here. There are two things you require before checking the plagiarism. Number one is a class ID and number two is the enrollment key. You will get both of these from your school, college or university instructor. As you can see here, enroll in a class. When you press this icon, you will see both class ID and enrollment key. Both of these you should require from your college instructor or your teacher who manage this Turnitin account or administer this Turnitin account on the behalf of your university. Come on, let's back to all classes. Here you can see this is my class ID and I have already created my class to check my plagiarism. When you have your class ID, first you have to keep your file in your computer or in your Google Share Drive. As I'm going to show you right now, just click on the class name. Here, as you can see, I have already checked some other reports. To check your report, you have to click on this submit button. Just click on the submit button. In these two cells is the name of your account, as appear here. And this is the submission title. You must enter the full name of your article, thesis, etc. because this name will show on your plagiarism report. Just type in your title. And locate your file wherever you kept it. Whether you kept it in your computer or in your Google Share Drive. You can also use Dropbox for this purpose. I have kept my file in my computer. So just choose this computer. This is my file for checking the plagiarism. Click on the file and just click open. As you can see, the file has been attached to this file. Just click upload. First, it will analyze your report here. It will show here a glimpse of your project where you can verify it. You can also check the other pages here by pressing these icons. This is the complete detail of your project, the file size, page count, the word count and the character in that particular project. Just came down here and click confirm. As you can see, your submission is complete. Now see below here, return to assignment list. Click on this button. As you can see, the plagiarism report came here. This is the plagiarism in this project. I have this project as a demo to show you how you can use this Turnitin account. Now, if you want to see the similarity, you can click on this view button. Click on view. It will show up another window. And in that window, you will see the whole project with plagiarism. It will take some time. Close this window. This red background shows that these words are the plagiarized. You can see here, the complete file is plagiarized. And when you want to see your actual percentage, you can see here. This is the percentage of the plagiarism in your report. And now if you want to download it, click on this button. And it will show up this small window. You always try to download this current view. So click on this current view. It will take some time to give you the downloaded file. As you can see, the file is downloading. Just open this file. You can see this is the demo plagiarism report that I have submitted. I write this title and the report printed with this title. So you should enter your full title of your article thesis so that you can directly print the main title on your plagiarism report. See below. Here it is. All the red fields are plagiarized. When you came down to your downloaded project, you will see the complete report here. This is the complete similarity index. This is the internet source. This is copied from publications. Come on, let's back to the Turnitin. As you can see, the 98% is the plagiarism in this project. You should try to keep it between 15 to 20 or less than 15. And one thing you must remember that you can submit only 3 submissions in 24 hours. So this is the simplest way you can use Turnitin account for your project. You can submit as many times as you want, but not more than 3 times in 24 hours. Every time when you try to submit your report, just click the resubmit button here. Now, as I mentioned that I'll show you a website where you can learn more about the plagiarism. For that, please come back to your homepage by clicking here. And now, this is the third tab. What is plagiarism? Click on this page and open in the new tab. Here you can learn more about the plagiarism, the prevention, the teaching, the plagiarism checking, the plagiarism research, and many more. When you go down to this website, you can see for students. Right click and open in a new tab. Here, these are the articles related to a student. You should read all these articles before starting your project, your thesis, or any article that plagiarism required. So, I hope you like this video. Please share this video with your friend for use Turnitin account. And don't forget to subscribe this channel. I see you in the next video. Till then, it's goodbye.